The Magna Vista Cavalier. Jerry Killam, a 6-0 junior, fouled out of the ball game with 11 points. He had 4 field goals and was 3 for 4 to field goal line. I mean, to free throw line for a total of 11. Epps played, didn't score. The only other player in the lineup to score for the Cavaliers was John Tatum, who had 2 field goals in the third quarter for a total of 4. All that totals up to 59 for the Cavaliers. Now for the Gate City Blue Devils, who really, in the second half, took control of the ball game in the third quarter. As Jeremy Housewright, for the night, had 2 two-point field goals, was 0 for 1 at the free throw line for a total of 4. David Jones came in the fourth quarter, had a 2-point field goal on a layup as the Devils executed their offense, I thought, brilliantly that time. And Jones stepped to the free throw line 5 times tonight and only hit 1, for a total of 3 for David Jones. Nathan Shreve played good defense, as always, hustled, got a big jump ball call late in the game where it went to the Blue Devils, third possession. And Nathan was 2 for 3 at the free throw line for a total of 2. Eric Weiniger picked up 2 fouls, was 1 for 2 at the free throw line for 1 point. But as always, Eric with that hustling defense. Chris Peters had 10 points at the half, picked up 4 three-pointers in the second half, 3 of those in the third quarter. For a total of 28 points as on the night. On the night, Chris Peters had 6 three-pointers for 18, 4 two-pointers for 26, and was 2 for 2 at the free throw line for a total of 28 points. John Britt didn't get into the game tonight. Tony McDonald, who had been held to 4 points on 2 field goals in the first half, stepped up in the second half. In the third quarter, he had 3 field goals and was 4 for 5 at the free throw line. And then again in the fourth quarter, picked up a couple more field goals and went to the free throw line 7 times, hitting 4 of those. So on the night, Tony McDonald had a total of 22 points. 22 points on 7 two-point field goals and 8 for 10 at the 8 for 11 at the free throw line for a total of 22. Justin Seaver came in the first half, gave the Devils a lift, had a 3-point play on a field goal and a free throw in the first quarter, had 2 field goals in the second quarter, had 2 more big field goals in the third quarter, and some mighty big rebounds during the game for Justin Seaver. He finishes the game with a total of 11 points. Nick Colabro played to handle the ball well, played good defense, had some big rebounds, didn't score any points in the game. Aaron Noe was 0 for 2 at the free throw line for no points. Sean Hutchins came in, played good defense, and hit the boards well for the Blue Devils, but didn't score. So the Blue Devils end up winning the Region 4 semifinal by a score of 71-59. They were led in scoring by Chris Peters, who had 28, Tony McDonald with 22, and Justin Seaver with 11, the only 3 players in double figures. The Cavaliers, only they had 3 players in double figures also. They were led in scoring by Keod Rogers, who had 18, Jerry Killam had 11, and Josh Duffy had a total of 12. But the Blue Devils win the ball game 71-59. They will play the winner of the Grundy-Patrick County semifinal game being played at Grundy tonight. We'll move to here tomorrow night to play the Blue Devils in the Region 4 championship. The Blue Devils have advanced with this win to the quarterfinals. Tomorrow night's game makes a difference if you win on where you play. If you lose, you probably do some long traveling. If you win, the possibility is you'll play at a school in Region 4, possibly a Virginia High or an Abington, and that would almost be like a home game for the Blue Devils. So Gate City with an awful lot to play for tomorrow night. Even though they're in the state quarterfinals, they would like to win so they can stay in this area close to home. This is Larry Shelton for my old buddy Mark Blanton, who had to exit the scene early and promised he'd be back tomorrow night. And for Clayton Dickey, who's been with us all year and does an excellent job on doing the filming and been running the recorder to get the coaches taped. And for our bag carrier, Eric Williams, from Gate City High School tonight, where the Blue Devils have won the first Region 4 semifinal game by a score of 71-59. We'll be back at the Devil's Den tomorrow night for the Region 4 finals. We'll see you again tomorrow night. Look for this game on Channel 30. We don't know when it'll be replayed, but check the scroll, and I'm sure the people at Channel 30 will try to get these semifinals on. Thank you and good night.